Hey everyone, so we're going to go over the fun part, which is nutrition. I'm going to do this over at least two videos, so look for part two, I know for sure, and I'll probably add a couple after. Let's go over structure, and then I'll show you how to actually apply this and when going into the next video as well. So first and foremost, there is no perfect time to eat, okay? So you have to, what matters is your bank balance. Your bank balance is how much food you're allotted to eat during the day. Your budgets of your bank balance are how you spend that accordingly. And the budgets in this case are going to be protein, fat, carbs, and vegetables, which is going to be individualized in quantity per individual. So you actually have an individualized meal plan, okay? So there's no perfect time. I'll give you some tips around your workouts in a second, but ultimately, just don't overspend for the day. Don't overeat, okay? If you want to eat all your food before noon, you can go for it. If you want to eat all your food after noon because you need to, I would recommend it, but you can go for it. All right. So there is no perfect time. There's no don't eat carbs after five. Don't worry about any of that stuff. Just eat what's on your meal plan. Time is less relevant. The only thing pertaining to time is before your workout, I would recommend that you have a shake about an hour to an hour and a half before your actual start time. So if you're working out 5:30. 4 o'clock, 4:30 the latest. If you want to have a full meal, I'd say about 2 to 3 hours before. So if it's at 5:30 start, you're really looking at between 2:30 and 3:30, throwing back your meal. So like a late lunch or whatever it may be for you, okay? So that's the only time specific. After your workout, there's science shows that there's benefits to get your carbs in after, but I would say just for this 6 weeks, just focus on eating something after, even if it's just a shake, okay? That refueling will make a difference. Right, so that's the only thing as far as time goes. Now, each and every one of you have an individual meal plan, and the main things that are individualized are the portion sizes. I gave you some examples here. These are all ones in my terrible handwriting in circle. That's a 1.5, 1.1, 1.5, and I forgot to add one there. But the bottom line is that pay attention to this, because the way it works is, let's take our protein category. For some reason, let's say you had a 1.5 in your little circle, and that correlates to your 6 ounces of chicken here. So you would simply multiply whatever the exact amount is in the box times the number you see. So for example, if this meal for you was one, it is exact for what you see, like 6 ounces of chicken breast. If it's 1.5, it'd be 9 ounces of chicken breast, okay? So multiply this times this. If it's 0.5, a lot of people will somehow miss this. If it's 0.5 for like your fat over here, you have half of whatever is shown in the box, okay? So the box is exact, you multiply it by your individual portion size for the category, okay? So I wanna clear that up. That always gets confused. I hate figuring that out with people week three, week four, all right? In between, you're gonna need protein shakes in between your meals, all right? And you can buy from us, which I do recommend. I do not recommend buying from other sources because we have two amazing product options right now. We'll have another by the time probably you watch this video. And if for some reason you do choose to go on your own, look, I can't stop you. I can only give you the best option that we have at the gym. But if, let's say you have a protein that is of high caliber, ask us. First, ask your coach, but second, only ask them if there's less than 3 grams of carbs, less than 3 grams of fat, and more than 24 grams of protein in one scoop. A lot of supplement companies, they'll give you 5 or 4 pounds of protein products, but it's actually 2 scoops to get the serving, all right? And a lot of times the serving is junk. It's a low quality protein that's not, the nutrition value is not there, and there's super high in carbs, super high in fats, or they're just super low in protein. So you actually have to get like 3 or 4 scoops to get the protein goal that you want. So that's how this is gonna work. If it's not on the meal plan, you don't need it, right? It's that simple. Well, can I have this? Is it on the plan? No? Okay, don't have it, right? As far as drinks go, no alcohol. It's not on the meal plan, so you can't have it. Black coffee, tea, or water, that's what you drink. It's that simple. You could ask a million times, like, what about this? If it's not on the meal plan, you can't have it, okay? Our recipes make this delicious and nutritious and fun. You gotta get creative, you gotta learn how to cook, and include some spices to flavor your food. So that's what's best for your body. That's what's best for your body fat. That's how you make this a lasting change. I'm gonna go over the 2 ways to do it and make this meal plan sustainable for you and your life. I'll show you what I do, and I'll show you what some other challenges do as well.